If we return merchandise to a vendor or we are dissatisfied with a service, vendors will sometimes decrease the amount we owe on a bill by giving us a credit towards that bill. What happens when a vendor gives you credit? Well, obviously, if accounts payable is the money amount that you owe, accounts payable will decrease when you record a vendor credit. And of course, whatever expense was on the original bill will be decreased by the amount of the credit, because if you paid less for that particular expense, you have less of that expense, and therefore that particular expense should decrease. In our vendor records, obviously a vendor credit will bring the vendor's balance down for that particular vendor. But you must note two important things. You must apply the credit to the correct bill to make sure the correct expense is decreasing. And in QuickBooks, you usually apply the credit at the moment that you pay the bill. Now, these are things that are slightly different from the way that we did credits back with customers. Let's take a look at an actual example. Let us imagine on May 9th, UPS gave us $75 credit specifically for bill number 8282. Now, when they give us a credit memo or some document that indicates that they're lowering the amount of the bill, that document is also a source document and should have its own reference number. Let us imagine that the credit that they issue us has the number 8282-CR1 to make sure we identify this particular document and this particular transaction. Before we record the credit in QuickBooks, let's take a look at the unpaid bills and let's take a look at the section for UPS. Right now, UPS has these two unpaid bills, and it is this bill that we are applying the credit to. When you enter a vendor credit, there is no separate window to enter a vendor credit. The window to enter the vendor credit is the enter bill window. And before you do anything else, change the option here from bill to credit. Again, it's the same enter bills window, making sure that the credit option is selected. Now we choose UPS, and you can see delivery expense automatically comes up. We can put the date, May 9th. Yes, it was May 9th. And the reference number again was 8282-CR1, or whatever reference number is on the document itself. And the amount of the credit is $75. Now, when we click Save and Close, we can see that there is a credit on the unpaid bills report. And the only reason the credit is there, instead of just decreasing a bill, is because we have not yet applied the credit to the bill. We can also see on the vendor balance detail at the bottom of UPS, there is a minus to the balance of UPS on the vendor balance detail for this credit. And of course, if we open the trial balance, we know that accounts payable will have this credit as a minus right at the very bottom of accounts payable. Here's the vendor credit decreasing. You can see this decreases the accounts payable. And of course, if we look at delivery expense, we can see that delivery expense has decreased by this credit. This credit has decreased the amount of delivery expense because if we paid less for delivery, we have less delivery expense. Here's how it usually works. On May 10th, we gave UPS check number 216 for payment in full to bill number 8282, and we used the $75 credit. That means the amount of the check is $1,000 even. So here we are at the unpaid bill report, and you can see that after we pay this bill, this credit should completely disappear from the unpaid bill report, and this bill should also disappear from the unpaid bill report. We open the vendor pay bills window the way we normally do, and we filter by UPS. Now, the date of the check was marked May 10th. The bill that we're paying now is this one. However, we have credits. So after we check the bill, you can click Set Credit, and you can see that UPS has a credit on the list of credits. In this case, the list only has one credit, but this list of credit already chose this particular credit. And when we click Done, you can see that another column is added here to the Pay Bills window, and you can see our check is $1,000. The credit we're using is $75, and that pays the amount due, $1,075. Click Pay Selected Bill, put in the check number, and then click OK. Done. When we go back to the unpaid bill report, both the credit and the bill have been removed. The credit has been applied, so it's no longer going to show up on the unpaid report, and the bill has been paid. 838282 has been paid. And this is what the unpaid bill report looks like after you apply the credit at the moment you pay the bill. It is important to note that you can still apply a credit without paying a bill. For example, on May 11th, Staples gave us a $300 credit for bill number 8484. You can apply the credit on May 11th, and you can wait until later to pay the remainder of the bill. Before we record the credit, we must look at the specific unpaid bill that the credit will be applied to. This is to make sure that the expense or the asset on the original bill is the same account that will be listed on the credit. Let's double click and notice that bill number 8484 was for equipment. Therefore, the credit that we get against that bill should also have equipment selected, because if we get a credit against what we paid for equipment, that means we paid less for equipment and the equipment account should decrease. From the main menu, we click Vendors, Enter Bill, and choose the credit option. We put in the date of the credit, which in this case was May 11th. The reference number will be the same as the bill number, except it will say dash CR2. So, dash CR2 for the credit. It's a credit of $300. Now, this bill was from Staples, and so is the credit. And on bill number 8484, we know that that asset that was purchased on that bill was equipment. Therefore, the credit against that bill should also be equipment. Now, when we click Save and Close, we notice there is a credit lingering here that remains for Staples for $300. And the credit will continue to show up on the unpaid bill detail until it is applied to a specific invoice. Excuse me, to a specific vendor's. Remember, our instructions say that we applied the credit immediately and will pay the bill later. So we're going to apply the credit, which means when we come back to the unpaid bill report, the credit will disappear, and this bill that we apply it to will decrease to $3,200. To apply the credit, click Vendor Pay Bills, sort by Staples, make sure that you have the date, which is the date that you're applying the credit. Now, you have to fool QuickBooks into believing that you're actually paying the bill, even though you're not. You have to click the check mark just to get the set credits available. If you don't click the check mark and pretend that you're paying the bill, you will not be able to click the set credits button. Click the set credits button. Notice, because this is the only credit on the list for Staples, it is automatically selected. If there were several, you would have to select the specific credit that you're applying to the bill. In this case, there's only one, so we only just click Done. And notice there's an additional column in the Pay Bills window, credits used, 300, and the amount to pay is 3,200. You must make this become zero. Remember, you are not paying the bill. So the amount to pay becomes zero and the credit used becomes 300. This technique will apply this credit to this bill without needing to pay. Again, make the money amount zero. Click Pay Selected Bill. Then click Done. Now notice, here we are back in the unpaid bill report, and we notice that Staples has no credit because it has been applied, and the bill it has been applied to, which is bill number 8484, has decreased to $3,200.